Secretary, if we start doing double the distancing, let's say 12 feet, is there any way to reverse course on this?
No, unfortunately not. But what it does show is that we weren't nearly as prepared as we should have been. I mean, to think that we've had over 90,000 deaths from COVID-19, and at least a third of those could have been prevented if the Trump administration had just taken this seriously. It's very tragic.
I'm actually going to lean in here a little bit and say I've been social distancing for years. I have a tendency to push people away, but it's hard to let people in when I've been hurt so much.
Kylie, Secretary, she does this all the time.
You need to take those walls down, girl. We have talked about that.
Lila, you know I get so awkward when I get attention. Now, moving on, another Trumper tantrum is brewing, and this time it isn't because his hamburger is cold. He's upset at CDC Director Dr. Robert Redfield. Informal conversations around what to do about Redfield have taken place as tensions between the CDC and the White House show no signs of abating. For standing up to the gaslighter in chief and looking fierce while doing it, Dr. Redfield is our Thicc AF Bear of the Week. Secretary, it was between you, him, and Michael B. Jordan. Now, in the spirit of sportspersonship, would you like to congratulate Dr. Redfield on this highest of honors?
Congratulations on being the Thicc AF Bear of the Week.
Wow, so brave of you. That makes you our Secretary Smoke Show Gracious Daddy of the Month, and our wigs are on the ceiling, honey.
Yes, on the ceiling, Mama.
Congratulations, Secretary.
Now, turning to world news, following our brave investigative report on the Chrissy Teigen-Allison Roman feud, the New York Times has decided to put Allison Roman on temporary leave. I think we need to go further so no one ever steps to Queen Chrissy Teigen again. We have rented a helicopter and are ready to capture Allison, fly her to someplace not on a map, and pull on her fingernails until she learns to do better.
How about being sentenced to a lifetime of wearing a poly blend?
Okay, Secretary Castro, we recently learned that you're a ripped AF sexy Latin prince. Lila told me I could say that. Now, we are blurring your nipples in protest of the censoring of women's nipples. But speaking of thirst traps, you have a new pack called People First Future, so you can raise massive sums of money like a literal boss, and we are here for it. Spill the tea.
I'm excited about it. I got into politics when I was young, at the age of 26, and I want to make sure that we help launch other folks that are intelligent, that are progressive, that are going to do the right thing for their communities.
I'm flattered, but what I do here is just too important. Hashtag slay. It's now time for the signal boost. During a high school graduation webcast, the governor of Mississippi read the names of graduates and someone slipped in a fake name.
Gavin Christopher Davis, Grayson Doss, Harry Ashcrack.
When I heard Harry Ashcrack's name read out, I didn't laugh. In fact, I was moved to tears. I thought about all the adversity faced by this fictional person. Harrison Ashcrack's parents, Milos and Genevieve Krakowitz, arrived at Ellis Island with nothing but the hairs on the crack of their ass. Under pressure to assimilate, they shortened their surname to Ashcrack. They opened a small business on the first floor of their tenement in Mississippi's Lower East Side, Ashcrack Hand Wash Laundry. Living on nothing but that dream, those hardworking, sweaty Ashcracks raised their family. Their son, Harrison, and daughter, Miss Sylvia, are massive for short, and sowed the lineage that would one day birth Harry Ashcrack. But one misguided graduate used that most American of stories as fodder for a joke because it sounded like an obscure slang term for the intergluteal cleft. Ashcracks are not funny. Because humans don't have tails, they keep horseflies from entering our anuses. So, to show my solidarity with generations of Ashcracks, I am changing my name to Kylie Ashcrack. #normalize it. And graduates, if you want to make fun of my name, you better also mention that I was my high school salutatorian. That's your signal boost. And this is Kylie Ashcrack signing off.